discussing about Baddhajeev, how we came in the control of Maya. And after this, how it can be liberated. It can be liberated. And have the service of lotus path Padma of Radha and Krishna. We have explained for 2 days. Now how many more days?
Four. Three more days.
Today?
Three more days.
और इसके बाद में 3 दिन है।
आज बता जाओ 3 दिन।
ठीक। ओह, first of all I want to tell about Govardhan Puja. Tomorrow is Govardhan Puja. In Braja, before Krishna, there was some demi and demigods worshipping. Krishna never wanted that it should be. He wanted to check out all these things. Especially those who have pride, anyone. Oh, it should be crushed. So they were doing Indra Puja. And thinking that Indra gives rain, and by rain grasses come, by grasses,
cows
and pond in water in ponds everywhere, and thus we are alive. So due to Indra, and before Indra puja of one day before, Mother Yashoda was cooking so many various preparations. Everyone in Braj. Then Krishna asked, "What Mother is doing?" I went to Mother and asked, but she rebuked me. Go. Go and play with boys. So, please, Father, you should tell me what she is doing. My birthday or what? Then, Father told, oh, you are going to do tomorrow Indra Puja. You fight, Father? So, he gives rain, he gives water, and he nurses us. Without him, no rain, nothing, and then our cows will die, we will die. Then Krishna told, where there is no Indra Puja or other places, if there is no rain, no grass, no they are living, no cows, why you are doing? Then Nanda Baba could not reply. Then, what should we do? Why not we should do the puja of Govardhan? Govardhan, 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 Gopi, Go, all. Really, he gives rain. He is high, so high that cloud comes and transformed into rain. He gives grasses. He gives water in so many ponds, like Manasi Ganga, like Kusum Sarovar,
Radha
Kund, Shyam Kund, Man Sarovar, everywhere. So, we should try to worship Govardhan. Then, Nand Baba accepted and he told all that we should tomorrow worship Giriraj Govardhan. And in the morning, he took all the preparation in their courts, millions of courts, and all gopi, millions and millions, they went to Govardhan, where now Anore Gram.
Anore village.
And they went there and they began to worship. Krishna at once became two, one in his own form, another on the Giriraj Govardhan, he became Haridev, like Gopal. And, but with 400,
no,
200. And then he began to tell, Anore, Anore. And Krishna became priest. He offered to go Raj Govardhan and told, oh, see, Indra came ever, he gave darshan, he gave any boon, nothing. But he is swelling like so. So he began to ask that anore, anore, bring more preparations. In a, with two hands he took all, and he took all the rush, water from Mansi Ganga, everywhere he took, all came in his mouth. And then he was telling, oh, more, more, more. But Krishna told, oh Prabhu, oh, we are very poor. We cannot give you so. Please be merciful. And then he became merciful. You can ask any boon as you like. Then what Nanda Baba and others asked boon, our Krishna should be always happy. Only this boon they ask. Then, after worshipping, oh, Indra became very. And after that they did parikrama. Those who are old on cart, bullock carts, those who are young, oh, dancing, singing with Krishna, Baladev, all doing parikrama. They did parikrama. And when they returned back to their home, Indra became very, very
angry, furious.
And he ordered seven
clouds.
That you should so much heavy rain like mushladhar,
elephant.
That breast should be demolished. They did 1, 2, 3 days, and Krishna came, hearing their cry, and he lifted Govardhan at once. And all gopis, cows, came. Unlimited they were, but they came in the that
shelter. Under
Govardhan. And 7 days barsha holo na ki? 7 days he came. Vajra also coming. And Govardhan was so happy that even thunderbolts were coming. Some pieces of stones were going on. But he was so happy that I am situated on the hand of Krishna. And then Indra realized, and he went in the shelter of Gavi, Surabhi. And she came, and then she prayed, Krishna became happy. And this is. So if anyone is doing Govardhan, everywhere in Brajo, everywhere in India, if Govardhan not, then they will make Govardhan by cow dung. And they will worship. And also, cow play will be there. Feeding cows, worshipping cows, worshipping Vaishnav, Brahman, Gurus, everyone. This is Govardhan Puja. And then Surabhi and Indra, with water what Aravat brought from Triganga,
Mandakini,
of Krishna Abhishek was done. And the water is in
Govindakund.
And he kept this name Govinda, Govindati, Gomane Ved, Gomane Indriya, Gomane Go, Gopi, Gabhi, all his. So his name is Govardhan. So anyone taking part, giving any preparation to him, even one
grain,
he will give. Lakshmi can bake anywhere, but that person has not to bake. So even in your house you can do. Here we are doing because I am here today. But you should do on Kartik month, in Kartik month, on
Annakut day,
after one day, Pratipada. Pratipada. First you should do puja of Gurudev, then Vaishnava, then Brahmin, then cows, then get to Govardhan, and prasadam should be distributed to all. Krishna bhakti will come. Now, Vardhan ki jai. We don't want anything from Krishna because he is Nanda Kumar, very
small boy.
He cannot fulfill our. We should try to fulfill his desire. No? Or if any desire, then go to Govardhan and he will fulfill all your desire. Nanda Baba, even Krishna used to go. Govardhan Tat is very high, will express any desires. Jantur Bai Bhava, Etasmin Jajan Yoni Manu Braje, Tasyam Tasyam Salavate Nibrate Birajyate. Sukadev Goswami is telling to Parikshit. Jiv, Jantu Mani Jiv. This Jiv, from beginning of the creation, Anadi Kaal, he is traveling in so many species of life. Everywhere, wife, children and my mind, everywhere. But never become satisfied. Never. You cannot be satisfied. If you are giving ghee in fire, it will increase. So it will not be controlled. But even that jeev, so if goes in the species of dog, cat, boar, hogs and pigs, very happy, he feels very happy. Never want to give up that body. What to human persons? And he never becomes vairagyavan, detached from worldly desires. So you don't think that, oh, this is the first time that we are doing marriage. Pigs, at a time, hundreds and thousands of wives. Wives. Your elephants, so many wives.
Monkeys.
You know? Buhawala. Very. Like this. So many wives. They are only. What are their duties?
Eat, drink, and be married.
No other things. No house. Nothing,
no job,
no shed, no job, nothing. To eat by
stealing glasses.
See, everywhere this is. Not to laugh, but to deeply think. Even we hearing and knowing and being in so many yonis.
Species of life.
But we are not satisfied. And we are not doing bhajan. We have some love and affection. But really you keep your heart, hand in your heart, tell that I have loved more Krishna than my wife, than my children. Do you serve Krishna more than your children? You make money. How much you spend for Krishna and how much for you your wife and your daughter and sons, how much? Then you can judge, oh, how much love and affection is for Krishna. So really, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is telling, oh, Maya ki moh. What meaning?
The bewilderment of Maya.
He is telling, oho, oho means
alas.
Even they have no barrier.
No detachment.
No detachment coming. And not serving Krishna. So you should all think this. And be like this. You cannot be satisfied by your sexual lives. Never and never. Oh, by previous and now fruitive karma. This soul sometimes became male, sometimes become lady, sometimes napunsak, no gender. In India, we have seen so many. They are called khoja. Kokhono devata. Souls comes from demigod, demigoddesses. Sometimes human. Or sometimes what? Like trees, creepers. If you will fell this occasion,
golden
opportunity, then you will have to go again in that. Anyone cannot save you, you must know. So determined in your heart. You cannot believe or believe, I don't know. Demigod, son of Nalkubar. Nalkubar and they became tree. It may be that trees were sometimes human. And again they have been this.
Someone who is Diksha, he can fall to an animal species.
What?
Anyone who has gotten Diksha initiation at any time, can he also fall back?
Yes, certainly. Certainly. Anyhow, in bad association, he has left everything, guru, his bhakti, everything, and he has come in like animals, eating meat, drugs and smoking and all these things, and making aparad in the bhakti, in the Lord's feet of bhakti and Vaishnava. Oh, he will go. Diksha means, I think if anyone has Diksha, he will not go down. There is a real incense Diksha. If Dibhigyan is coming, how he can fall? I think that Diksha was not appropriate, not Brahma Diksha.
Formal Diksha.
Anusthanik Diksha.
Formal.
We should see. In Jaiva Dharma, you should see Vijay and Kumar and that Diksha, they took Diksha and became friends. And they saw what? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, all associated dancing and singing. Real Diksha. Our Diksha is generally
formal
Diksha, not formality, but formal. For Pancharatriki. To have qualification. We are not qualified. But for qualification, it is given. There is no other process. Meaning. after creation, Brahma began to think, oh, I created. But I see what created? Gross body and subtle body. Oh, Jivas was very unhappy. Very, very. Everywhere. They are forgotten Krishna. And they are entangled and suffering so much. What to do? How I can make them happy? Then Bhagavan Brahma Karsnena Tririnviksha Manishaya Tadardhasya Kutastho Ratiratman Jato Bhavet. He began to think what to do for these jivas suffering. As Krishna thinks, as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Advaitacharya, you know, he was very what? For jivas. I will call Krishna that he should help them. And if he will not come, then I will destroy whole world. And he took one tulsi, three leaves, and with Ganges water, and he began to worship Krishna. Krishna satisfied. And then he came. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming, one cause is that Advaitacharya called him. And in the end, thinking and thinking, then he came to conclusion that if anyone will have any attachment, any way with Krishna, especially if the rati will be in the lotus feet of Krishna, then they may come. So, we can only be happy, not by any material things. You cannot be happy. Your lust or desiring so many will increase so much. So much. Only accept something to maintain you. Only that. And then we should have rati. Jena kena upayena krishne mano niveshaya. This I have called only for this to you all, not for anything else. Not anything. That anyhow you should have bhakti. This is our guru parampara idea. So I want that all you should follow these instructions. Shruti, Veda telling to Krishna, praying. Pivanti ji Bhagavata Atmana Satan Kathamritam Savanaputeshu Sampritam Punant te Vishaya Vidushitasayam Bhajant Tatcharana Sarojasa. And Brahma is thinking that those who will chant, remember Krishna by ears, this is like a cup, two cups, who will drink the sweet pastimes of Krishna by ears, oh, they will be so liberated. So we should try to hear. As much as you will hear, Krishna will come in your heart and he will be like a bandhu, he will take all your everything. This is the easiest way. Parikshit Maharaj was going to die in 7 days. What he adopted? What method? Oh, I should hear Bhagavat. At once, when desire came, at once Mahabhagavat Sukadeva Goswami came. And in the meantime, of thousands and thousands of, not less than 60,000 kichi,
or
Rishi's mercy, like Nara, Pyas, Parashar, all so many. Okay. Then he was thinking, oh, very wonderful. This is not a course. Actually, this is boon. To see any of them, to have a darshan of these rishis, by smaran, what becomes? All evils goes away. And now they are all here. So, I don't think that it is course. It is really benediction. Then, Shrutis are telling, here, to obtain these things, to follow these things, Sadguru Charanashya Nitanta Avashya. Sadguru Charanashya. To take shelter in a lotus feet of a Sadguru, not Guru. Sadguru, everywhere Sadguru. So those who have Sadguru, and from him, we should hear Hari Katha. I think that realized Vaishnava all Guru. We think them all Guru. Especially like Siksha Guru. Diksha Guru one, but like Siksha Guru. I will come to this point, how one met so many Guru. Avadhut. What was his name? Dattatreya. He met
24
gurus. So we should do Siksha Guru. And their level should be somewhat, maybe gradation, but they should be sincere. Etavan lokeshmin punsam dharma parashmita bhakti yogena tannam grahanati. Or then Narhari, you go to house and then bring your guitar and then at once. Where is your helper? Then in 1 year she will come. Everything I can give, but no seat I can give. You should begin as in. What is best for you? It is very hard to have a seat. You can sit there. By the side of Devi, you can. Thank you.
Krishna Kanti, where?
Chanting in the names of the Lord, chanting, for you chanting, chanting the names of the Lord, chanting, chanting, chanting the names of the Lord, chanting, chanting the names of the Lord. Hiranyakashi Pumaskin, evil one will see. He bargained with Lord Brahma for immortality. Not to die in the day, not to die in the night. Not to die in the land, not to die in the sea. Not to die by animal, not to die by man. He wanted to live eternally. Pull out the boy, the body, the son of this demon king. His father's pride and joy will see till the earth and sing. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Bolo bolo.
Chanting, chanting, chanting the names of the Lord. Chanting, chanting,
chanting the names of the Lord.
Chanting, chanting, chanting the names of the Lord. Chanting, chanting,
chanting the names of the Lord.
This chanting made that king so mad, he tried to kill his son. But I kept chanting Krishna's name, it could not be done. He threw him to demons that put him in oil, put him out in the wind and rain. Well, I kept chanting Krishna's name, so it was done in vain. Hiranyakashi Puranya,
brother, it's your God here.
He struck a column with his fist. Lord Narsingha appeared. It wasn't by day, it wasn't by night, it wasn't on land, it wasn't on sea. It was not by animal, it was not by man. He was killed by the Supreme Personality. Chanting, chanting, chanting the names of the Lord. Chanting,
chanting the names of the Lord.
Chanting, chanting, chanting the names of the Lord.
Chanting, chanting, chanting the names of the Lord.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama,
Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Bolo bolo.
Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna,
Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna,
thank you. Another demo. Tomorrow Krishna Kanti, what name? Kanta. He should be ready here. And also Janava tomorrow. Then Sukadeva Goswami is telling to Parikshit, be careful and hear. Labdhva sudurlabham idam bahusam bhavante manusyam arthadam manityam api hadira turnam jatet napatet anumrit tujavat nise asaya visaya sarvata khadusha. What meaning? You stand up and explain.
Srila Gurudev has asked me to explain this verse. Labdhva sudurlabhamidam bahu sambhavante. After many, many births, one has gone through many species, through animal species, plant species, and finally one has come to the human form of life. The special quality of the human form of life is that one is able to practice Krishna consciousness. One is able to realize that which is actually for one's supreme benefit. Otherwise, in animal species, ahara nidra bhayamaitunam cha, these things can be done, eating, sleeping, mating, and defending, the same as in the human form of life. So in the human form of life, one can get Sadguru, and under the guidance of Sadguru, one can take advantage. Otherwise, if one does not take advantage of the special opportunity afforded by the human form of life, there is a danger that one may again fall into the lower species of life. So therefore, it is given very emphatically, nishreyasaya, for our benefit. We must take this opportunity and not waste the human form of life by engaging in bhajan under the guidance of Sadguru.
Turnam na jatet. What is the meaning of turnam na jatet?
Do not turn away. Do not go down again.
Advance. Don't waste a minute time. Otherwise, next moment you may die. So, turnam na jatet. Patet anumittu javat nishesaya. Sit down. What is nishesaya? Nishesaya. Vishaya khalusa prasa. Turnam jatet na patet anumittu javat nishesaya.
Sense gratification is available in all species of life.
You should understand the fact. What is nishesaya?
In the third line of the verse, they stated, Turnam yateta napatet anumritu javan. Turnam, at once, take up the practice of Krishna consciousness. Why? Na chalet anumritu javan. Again, you will go into the chain of birth and death. One should not do this. Why? Nishreyasaya vishaya kalu sarvatasyat. Vishay. Sense gratification. This is not for our benefit. And that sense gratification is available everywhere. Kalusaya Vatarshat. It's available everywhere without any endeavor. In other words, here Shukadeva Goswami Pad is explaining that why is it that we neglect the path of Krishna consciousness? Why? Because we have some desire for material comfort, luxury, sense gratification. Yet, all this material sense gratification, it comes by itself of its own accord without any endeavor whatsoever on account of the karma that we performed in our previous lives. Therefore, there's no need to endeavor for that. Just endeavor for Krishna consciousness and all those things will come anyway. And if one will neglect the endeavor for Krishna consciousness, then, oh, this will not be Shreya. This will not be for one's benefit, but it will bring about one's downfall.
What is Shreya? Oh, only Rati in the lotus feet of Krishna is Shreya. Otherwise not anything. What we are going to do in this world? Accept bhakti. All are like not Shreya.
Prayer.
All are prayer, not Shreya. Only bhakti is Shreya.
Ultimate benefit.
Ultimate benefit. And it begins from where? Sadhu Sangha. Then Shraddha comes. Shraddha, two kinds of Shraddha. From beginning. Hearing Shastra, Lobhamayi. Another, by hearing Shastra, and it is our duty by this. Lomai Shraddha, gradually it comes in Raganuga. And Vaidhi Bhakti, Aishwarya Bhakti. When Raganuga Bhakti will come, oh, this is necessary. Vaidhi Bhakti also not so much. Hi, Shreya. But Nishreshaya, only this Raganuga Bhakti. So, Turnam Jate Tana Patet. Before dying, time is not certain. Parikshit Maharaj is 7 days. But we know, just we are here, we may go out and we may go die. Here also, no certainty. In a moment, so those who are wise, intelligent, they should begin from there. Don't be weak. It is easy to say, but very
hard
to
practice.
So we should try to practice it. Again, Sukadeva Goswami is telling, Ayu harati vai punsham uddhanastanta jannasau tasyarte jatkhano nitau uttam sloka vartaya. Selected slokes by Srimad Bhakti Vinod Thakur. Ayu harati vai punsham. Can you explain? You?
So Sukadeva Goswami is quoting this slok. Ayu haroti vai pungsam uddhanastanca jannasau tasaitirachano nita uttama sloka vartaya. We have seen, or we are seeing every day, sun is rising and then setting. So, and who has taken birth, they must have to die one day. But what he did in his human lives, you have to consider about that. Ayu harati vai pungsang. Ayu means lifetime. Stolen by whom? And whose? Vai pungsang. Pungsang means all living entities. Ayu harati vai pungsang. Uttamastra jannasau. Every day sun is rising and setting, day and night. By this way, sun are stealing our lifetime. Then how we can escape from this? Tasthai tajya chanoni tottam shloka vartaya. If we discuss among ourselves the glory of Uttam Shlok, Uttam Shlok means by Uttam Uttam Shlok, by very beautiful, beautiful Shlok, to whom we pray, then Uttam Shlok. Actually, Uttam Shlok name of is Krishna. So, if we pray Krishna by very beautiful Shlok, like selected Shlok of Srimad Bhagavatam, which you have heard from Siddha Gurudev Lotus Leaf, Tastarya Chamitabhya, which time we spend discussing Harikatha, then our life will be successful. That time, Surya cannot, sun cannot steal from us. And if you not do so, then our life will go vain. And if we, when we meet together, each other, if we discuss Harikatha, then our life will not be waste. If you not do so, then you have to suffer. And if you do so, then next birth will get more higher birth and more higher sadhusanga. And gradually, where Mahaprabhu's pastime is going on, after that, where Krishna's pastime is going on, we'll take birth there and we'll do bhajan, higher and higher bhajan. Then one day we'll attend the associateship of Sriman Mahaprabhu and Divine Kapil. Hare Krishna.
Thank you.
Bansha Karvatar.
You have heard the story. Two rats cutting two branches. Yeah, day and night. But comes from sun. Oh, he is cutting our lifetime. I don't know how many days are still, or how many hours, or how many moments. But he is cutting. Only he cannot cut those who are chanting and remembering Krishna. Not their days. So, श्रीमता श्रद्धया नित्यं गृहतश्च स्वचेष्टितं नाति दीर्घेण कालेन भगवान विशदे हृति प्रविष्टा कर्णरन्ध्रेण स्वानं भाव सरोरुरहं धुनोति समलं कृष्ण सलिलं यथा शरत् को एक्सप्लेन भक्ति सार ओ यू It has been explained.
Srinvatam sadhyanitam grinatas chastra chastitam nathde kalena mata bhagavan vishathe ridi. In this verse, Sri Sukadeva Goswami explains to Bhikshu Maharaj, you must do five things, then your spiritual life will be successful. Srinvatam, first you have to hear. Sri Gauga Maharaj used to ask, who is hearing? All are not hearing. All is going in one ear and out the other. Hearing is an art. Unless one is completely surrendered, how can one hear? Srinvatam, Sradhya. One must hear with faith. Nityam, continuously. Nityam Bhagavat Sevya. Every day one must make an effort to hear the Srimad Bhagavatam. Grinatas. Everything we hear we have to accept. Not like filtering. I like this, but I don't like that. And most importantly, but most difficult, chasva chastitam. One must, everything one hears and accepts with faith, chasva chastitam. One must practice and endeavor in one's own life. Nadhi kalena mataha. One who does these five things in no time at all, Bhagavan Vishatedi, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, will manifest in his heart.
Thank you. Here, importance of Shraddha. If you are Shraddha, very easy, very easy, very easy. Hearing what? What difficulty, problem. But there should be Shraddha. And if you have Shraddha and hearing, then by Shravani, hearing, at once, without delay, here he tells that alpa kaler madhya, after some days, after some time. But in the beginning,
Sukadeva Goswami has told, Bhagavate Mahamuni Krite Kimba Pare Vishwari Sabda Avaruddhate Atra Kritavi Susuvi Tatkhanat. What is the meaning Tatkhanat?
Immediate.
So how wonderful. So we should hear Harikatha. We want to hear Vishayakatha. Instead of that, we should hear Harikatha with Saddha. In no moment, at once, Krishna will come in your heart. And what he will do as a Laukik Bandhu? Karna Randhrena Swanam Bhava Saruruham. Bhasarun Bhava is like lotus. Dhunoti Samalam. He takes away, wash
out
all the worldly desires, aparad, anartha, everything. So one is Shraddha is needed. Here, what you hear with Shraddha, Krishna will go in your heart and do everything. Khatango Ram Raja. Vishnu you have Mohottam Sarvam Utsrijya Gatvan Abhayam Hari. Raja Khatvang Rishi.
Rajarshi.
Who went to Swargalok, heaven, to fight with demons. He defeated them. And the son of Shankar, Kartikeya, now he became general.
Commander general.
And the demigods told that we are very happy. You can have any boon.
And you can stay here forever.
You should have any boon. He told that I want liberation and to serve Krishna. Oh, that we cannot give. Then if you cannot give, then I have nothing to ask any boon for you. Please
tell me
how many days or how many years I will. Oh, only 12 minutes or
24 minutes.
Oh, take me to earth in Vrindavan anywhere. And he brought him. At once he dedicated fully to Krishna. Any moment, Kantvang Rishi. Sarvamusrijya means?
Give up everything.
He gave up everything what he has. He has big kingdom, wife, children, attachment for them, everything. He cut it and he sat and
meditated
and at once in a moment he went.
Krishna.
So there are so many examples. Parasparam, parasparanu kathanam, pamanam bhagavat jasah, mitho rati, mitho tusti, nibhrti, mitha atmana, smaranta, smaranantascha, mitho alga haram harim, bhaktya sanjata bhaktya, bibhut utpat kalyatana. But the Jew conditioned soul, they should follow bhakti, vaidhi bhakti. Raganuga bhakti is very rare, very rare. We should not try to pretend that I am Raganuga. They should follow bhakti. And by this, especially in our sampradaya, Gaudiya Vaishnava sampradaya, reading Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Charitamrita, though it appears Vaidhi Bhakti, but very soon it will bring Raganuga. So we should follow Vaidhi Bhakti. From Vaidhi Bhakti will come Bhavat. What is sadhan? We should know. What we are doing or not sadhan, we are chanting, remembering, without aim. Oh, Krishna Prem will come. No. What is sadhan bhakti? कृति साध भावा स्वसाधन विदा नित्य सिद्धस्य भावस्य प्राकटन रिदि साध्यता. व्हाट मीनिंग?
माइक्रोफोन प्लीज.
Srila Gurudeva needs to speak about this verse of Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu manifested by Srila Rupa Goswami Pad. It is paribhasha, the definition of sadhan. He's saying kriti sadhya bhavet sadhya bhavasa sadhanabhidam. Kriti means by the senses. When our senses are engaged in the angas of bhakti, such as hearing, chanting and remembering, in what way? Kriti sadhya bhavet sadhya bhava. In such a way that the sadhya bhava, or the goal of our life, will be attained, then sadhanabhida. This is called sadhana. What is the potentiality of sadhana? We should know that the goal of our life is to attain bhav bhakti. For those who are conditioned in this world, their aim and object is bhav bhakti. Rati, that is one of five types. One permanent foundational emotional relationship with Krishna, either in Santa Dasya Sakyavatsalya or Madhurya, especially in the line of Srila Rupa Goswami, in Madhurati is the aim and objective. So when hearing and chanting and remembering, that means the senses of this body and the mind are engaged in the process of devotion with the aim and object of attaining sadhya bhav, that goal, Krishna Rati, then this is called sadhana. So nitya siddhasya bhavasya prakatyam ridhi sadhyata. What is the potentiality of this practice? The potentiality is that nitya siddha bhav, one mood which is eternally perfect and hidden. This is our real treasure. Hidden within the heart, prakatyam ridhi sadhyata, it should become manifest. Therefore, if a devotee is hearing, chanting and remembering, but they have no idea what is the aim and object, what is Krishna Rati, or what type of Krishna Rati, then their practice can never be called sadhana bhakti. Therefore, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur has explained that when the jiva is anatta grasta, he is covered by so many anattas, his hearing, chanting, remembering is not sadhana, it is sadhana abhas. When anattas are clearing, some steadiness will come, little taste will come, ruchi, at that time he understands bhakti tattva. Yatra alpa ruchir eva syad bhakti tattva avabodhikaha. If a little ruchi will come, then he understands bhakti tattva, and then he can think very nicely, oh, what is the goal of my life? And try very hard to attain that goal through guru seva, vaishnava seva, and very intensely hearing, chanting and remembering, oh, this will be actual sadhana bhakti. To begin from there.
That is bhav bhakti. By sadhana bhakti, we can attain bhav. But what is really bhav bhakti? Shuddha sattva, visheshatma, prema sujjans samyabhat, ruchidhi chittam masin, kridasau. Shuddha sattva. Oh, very. Shuddha sattva means the mood of Radhika or Gopis or Brajavasi, you can, but highest in Gopis and Radhika. How he loves Krishna, this mood. And by following them, that mood partly comes to heart of devotees. That is called Shuddha Sattva. But Visheshatma, what is Visheshatma? That mood, two things, Samved and Hladini, sar essence of both. Bhav, bhav, you know? What means bhav?
Bhav.
Transcendental emotion. I don't think so, but there is no any word for bhav. prema san jan su sambhava, essence of both Ladini and Sambhi, on Sambhi, Sandini, our heart, vaiti disan, disan, then it is called Shuddha Sattva Visheshatma. This is the prem su jan su sambhava. If prem is Surya, oh, little part of that. Abhas.
Semblance.
Then it is gone. What it does? Ruchi bhi. Chittamma. What ruchi? Ruchi here?
That's such kind of bhagavata.
Abhilasha. Krishna ko prapt karne ki abhilasha jo hai. Sauhat ityati. These are
three.
And then, oh, chit becomes
very smooth.
Smooth and melting. That is called rati or bhav. So, our mode should be that how by sadhan we can
attain,
manifest that bhav. If you are doing chanting, remembering, but mode is there, our goal is there, then it will come. And when bhava bhakti will come, then our mood will be to attend prem. These are processes. But how it will come? Very easy method. Parasparanu kathanam pavanam bhagavat jasah mitho rati mitho bhakti tushti nibhati atmana Smaranta smaranta. Bhagavat jas, the glories of Krishna, sweet pastimes of Krishna. Each other telling and hearing. When two bhaks are there, having the same mood, then whole day and night, like Rup and Sanatan, like Mahaprabhu Raya Ramananda and like Srinivas Pandit, whole night doing kirtan, no sleepiness, like this. Paraspar, each other doing. What? One